Well, Christmas time is coming around the corner, and I'm getting someone in the family a new guitar with a laptop and guitar rig 5. I picked this up used. He really doesn't need it, but I figured he could probably use this if he wanted to amplify the signal out of the laptop or run it straight to the guitar. It's an RMS amplifier. I don't know too much about it. RMS-200 guitar amplifier. Only issue with it, it does power up, is the pot. When I went to pick it up, it was spinning, but it was actually just spinning on the shaft. The volume pot is totally seized, but the tone one is, that's a little tight, but it's still moving. Probably just needs to be lubed, but this one is totally solid. So we're going to open it up and see what it looks like on the inside. We just have to take the 4 screws out here and the back plate will come off. Okay, we've got the back off. Got some foam on the back. There's the cord. Yikes. Look at that, eh? They don't even mount that to anything. It's just floating in there. That's scary. It's amazing that it hasn't been ripped off. There's the speaker. It's a 30-watt speaker. Nice foam surround. Not a bad speaker considering how cheap the amp is. There's the amplifier there. I have no idea what chip that is. Jeez, look at that. That's not even mounted to anything, it just floats. Cheap. This is gonna be a pain in the ass getting at that pot. I'm gonna have to disassemble the whole bloody thing. That's probably why it was left. I think what I'll try first is I'll try lubing it from the front. And turning it with a pliers or whatever, see if I can free it up that way. Save taking that apart. Okay, there's not much actually holding the amplifier plate in. Just the 2 screws on the top for the handle, and it just basically drops out the front. So we're going to drop it out and replace the pot. It's not. It's beyond repair. I couldn't even turn it with the wrench, and it was all deformed and everything else. So, by the time I did free it up, it wouldn't work very well. I'm gonna go through some of this wiring too. This wiring on the speaker here doesn't look so healthy. Maybe it's it's all right. I'm pulling off. Okay, so let's slip that out. One bolt takes out the board, which is mounted to there, not very well. There's the pot. You can see it's kind of deformed compared to the other one. So someone's had a problem with it for a while. This one's kind of tight too. But I'm hoping I can get a little oil in there and loosen it up a bit. That's probably all it is. Is the oil's dried up. It's been sitting in someone's basement. There's the chip. It's a TA7205AP. It's made by Toshiba. It's mounted very precariously. A little bit of vibration before it busts the pins on it. Don't see any swelled up caps, though this one here is questionable. Don't really care about the amp. As long as we get the volume going, at least you can turn it down. I think it's probably all the way up. Okay, you can oil them. This one here was pretty tight, and I dropped a little oil in between the shaft and the main part of the pot, and it's loosened right up. Every turn it gets better and better, so I don't have to change the tone. See, it's loosening it up really nice. Wow. The more you turn it, the better it gets. So I'm going to try and free that one up and straighten it out. If I can get away with doing that, I will. So changing the pots, pain in the butt. That's not bad. Gotta try the other one. Okay, that's not bad. All it was is the jack wasn't grounded. Like, this is grounded, so. Works better now. As the overdrive works. So. It's working. I ended up replacing it with a different type. This one's just a slot. And just by luck, I had a pot or a knob that pretty much matches the other one, so it's good enough. Well, the volume pot doesn't exactly line up with the numbers, but it's good enough, right? It's working. Cool. Later.